Welcome to our second video newsletter for the fifth grade Heinz House this year. This week, I was able to get some grown-up feedback from some of you at home. I've decided to include some here that I think will be very beneficial for you guys at home. First up, we have a sample student schedule. Yay!
You can see on the left column here, I have listed the times throughout the day that your student will be working on things. The right column includes all of the activities that your student could be working on throughout the course of the day. Olathe administration has set forth the expectation that online students will be getting 360 minutes of instructional time each day, and as long as your student is sticking to this schedule, they will be getting just that.
I will also link it below in the description box, so if you would like to screenshot it, save it, you can do so. Last week, I linked in the description box the math parent tip sheets for you guys. After getting some parent feedback, I've also decided to include some math videos. Hopefully, they will be more helpful than just the tip sheets. So, after the past 2 weeks of instructional time, I have noticed that a lot of us are missing maybe just one or maybe a lot of assignments. So, this week we are going to focus on catching up. I will be including another new thing for you guys that hopefully will help you keep track of what you need to be doing, not only on a daily basis, but also if you are behind, what you need to do to catch up. So, this is called our must-do, may-do catch-up sheet.
You can see on the far left side of the screen is the must-do category. These are activities that your student needs to be completing each day. The catch-up section is in the middle. That includes activities that your student needs to complete in order to be 100% caught up in class. Basically, these are just missing assignments that need to be turned in. Lastly, if your student has absolutely nothing to do, they have finished their work for the must-do section and the catch-up section, they may look into the may-do section for ideas of things to do. Of course, grown-ups, you are welcome to include activities of your own for your student in the may-do section.
Linked below in the description box is our new spelling list. This week, we are going to be completing our math testing. Math testing is going to be on Tuesday, which we are going to have a unique schedule for. Reading math testing is going to be on Thursday, and we are also going to have that same unique, interesting schedule.
Here is what our schedule is going to look like on those two math testing days. You can see that from 9 a.m. to noon, I will have a group of students meeting with me and the other half of the class completing independent assignments. And then from 12:30 p.m. to 3:30 p.m., that group will just switch. So the other group will be with me completing math testing, and the other group will be completing their independent assignments for the day.
All right, let's take a quick look at what our week in math is going to look like. On Monday in math, we are going to complete lessons 9 and 10. Tuesday is going to be our map day, so we are not going to do a math lesson. When we're looking at Wednesday, we are going to be completing math lesson 11. Thursday is another math day, but it's reading, so students will be completing the math lesson 12 independently that day. I will pre-record a lesson for that, and they will just follow along. On Friday, we are not going to do any new content. We are simply going to review lessons 9, 10, 11, and 12, which we learned that week, and then we are going to take an assessment over it. All right, let's go ahead and move on and take a look at what reading is going to look like this week. This week in reading, we are starting a new story called The Quest for the Tree Kangaroo. On Monday, we are going to start by making predictions about what the story might be about before we read. We are also going to build some background knowledge about what a tree kangaroo is, where they're located, are they endangered, what's going on with them. I've never heard of a tree kangaroo, so we're gonna build some background knowledge. Also on Monday, we are going to do that very first read. I will be doing a read aloud. While I go through, I will be asking them comprehension questions along with some questions that help extend their thinking. But we are going to be pre-teaching the vocabulary for this story. We are going to be talking on Tuesday about domain-specific words, which are basically words that you wouldn't normally hear in other content areas. This text is very informational, and I think that that type of reading is something that's super important for kids, especially as they start growing up, going to high school, and hopefully even going to college in a few years. Once we've finished talking about those domain-specific words, we're going to go back through and I'm going to do another read-aloud for the kids. While I'm doing that read-aloud, students are going to be listening for those domain-specific words and writing down what they hear. Please remember that Tuesday again is our math map testing day, so all of this is going to be asynchronous and pre-recorded, so your student will be doing this activity independently. On Wednesday, again, I bet you guessed it, we are going to read that story again. We are going to go over the domain-specific words that your student did independently the day prior. And then also, we are going to talk about cause and effect within the story. We are going to do one example all together as a whole group, and then we are going to break apart into two breakout rooms, one room with a para, one room with me, and then do our own cause and effect board. Thursday is our map reading day, so we will not be doing any reading activity. On Friday, we are going to take our test and discuss what we learned from our story this week. All right, let's talk about spelling and phonics. Remember that I have linked below our 15-word spelling list for week 3. On Monday, we are going to start spelling and phonics instruction in our small group time. Students may need to complete the activity after we're done, though. We are going to be talking about our phonics pattern for that week. Students are going to model on our whiteboard feature on Zoom how they would complete the phonics activity. Students are also going to need to complete this activity for all of their spelling words. However, they will not be turning this into me for a grade. On Tuesday for spelling, we will be doing our sound mapping activity. I will be releasing a video that shows how sound mapping will work for this activity. On Wednesday, your student will be doing a word sort for their spelling slash phonics list. Spelling on Thursday, students are going to be completing a word chain on Thursday. All right, Friday is going to be our spelling assessment. Again, that is going to be through Nearpod, just like it has been the past 2 weeks. All right, let's go back to the beginning of the week and talk about science. So we were just able to finish our social studies unit about geography, and so that moves us into our very first unit of science. What I can tell you is that we are going to be starting to talk about matter this week. We will not finish the matter unit, but we are going to at least introduce it and get through probably about half of our instruction. All right, next up, we're going to talk about writing. This week, we are going to work on applying those 6 traits of writing. First up, on Monday, students are going to write 7 fifth grade level sentences about what they think our journey story about the tree kangaroo is going to be about. These are strictly predictions. They should not be looking into it at all. They should not be looking up tree kangaroos or reading our story. This is just a prediction based on their background knowledge. On Tuesday, students are going to complete a brainstorming activity. The prompt for this writing activity is going to be the happiest moment of your life. I will be providing a template for that brainstorming activity, so no worries there. When we get to Wednesday, I will be doing a little bit of instruction about transition words. We are going to brainstorm what kinds of transition words we could include in our story. On Thursday, remember this is another map day, so this activity is going to be 100% independent. Students are going to do their best to complete one whole page of writing about the topic that they brainstormed about. On Friday, we are going to do a show and tell of our writing. Students are going to not only show us their brainstorming that they did, but they will also be reading to us their rough draft that they have created. All right, our very last thing to talk about for this week is social and emotional learning. On Monday, your student is going to be learning about proactive and reactive language. On Tuesday, we are going to be completing a lesson from Second Step, which is the district-wide social-emotional learning curriculum. My hope for this activity on Tuesday is that I will be making a video, posting it to Nearpod, and through the video, it will be pausing and asking them questions. This lesson is all about empathy, and hopefully it goes really well. On Wednesday, your student is going to be completing an interview for the Second Step lesson that we talked about the previous day. On Thursday, your child is going to be learning about the circle of control. This is also something that we talk about with Habit 1 from The Leader in Me. On Friday, during our PM meeting at 1:30, students are going to have the opportunity to share the interview that they did on Wednesday.
All right, I think that's everything I have for you. As usual, let me know if you have any questions, comments, or concerns, and I can't wait to see you next time. Hasta la vista!